When he was in preschool, his artworks were not really that good, but he asked for painting lessons one summer before he went to grade one. He said he rarely asks for anything and expresses himself not much, but he asked, "Can I have painting lessons?" The condition was, "Give me good grades and then I'll enroll you in painting." So we did. We were lucky enough that Gallery Francesca, which is run by the Chausas, Armano. Mm-hmm. He's a friend, so they opened up a workshop for that summer. So I got to enroll him because he had good grades. And then they saw that he really likes to do it. He's really engrossed every time. He likes to paint landscapes, actually. He would like, he would want mine to listen in his work. And initially, they were all more dominantly colored green. And then the coaches would gradually introduce different colors for him to use. And eventually, he did like colors. But what we noticed was when he was growing up, his work would be affected by how he really does feel. Because there was a time in grade 7, he was like having a hard time transitioning from grade school to high school, losing a friend to another school. And first time he got a line of 7th grade. So he was like, during that time, his artworks were like, walang light, it's dominantly dark. And then after a while, medyo gumaganda na yung mood niya, he went back to colors. This was after that period that he was sad. It helped a lot because it calms him down. If he's stressed out in school or like after exams, he would really request, "Mommy, I need are you going to paint?" "Yes." "When are you going to paint?" "After exams." So, but he only paints in the gallery. It's like, ganun kasi sila, they're compartmentalized.
Yeah.
They only do certain things. They wouldn't paint. He wouldn't paint at home even if the materials are there. He would want to paint in the gallery. We tried to encourage him into doing other things. Make him do what he really wants to do because we cannot make him do what he doesn't like. With our kids, we want them to be independent. It's like what he wants to do, but at the same time, earning a living with what he does and being independent. Although most of us are doing already estate planning, because he is special needs. He would need assistance. But we are trying as much as possible to make him more independent, decide for himself, be more assertive. It's although sometimes he gets overconfident, if he thinks he's smarter than another kid, he would like blurt it out. Okay. The other day he asked me a question. One time he asked, like, when do we expect him to be independent? What's a good paying job? And then he blurted out, "Because I do not know what I really want to do, Mom, yet. If I would work at," he said, "if I can work at Unilab, or I would go to the institute that you said in Texas that teaches autistic people to do game programming, game development." See, he's like, he's thinking that far, actually, which is quite surprising. He has a foresight on what he does, but he overthinks and gets worried. And hopefully, he will get through this and, you know, and that he would know you're always there, the family, that Jada and his little sister and I are always behind him in whatever he decides on later.